Good morning and welcome to the live stream. Today I have my friend Pam Gomez from Oh Natural Aromatherapy, and we're going to talk about Google Chrome. We're doing another Media Mogul Moment, so stay right there. That's coming right up. Hi guys, Ileane Smith here, and if you're like me, you like using the Google Chrome browser. So I want to go over to the Google Chrome browser. So make sure that you know how to navigate the browser and to make sure that you keep it updated so you can be safe, secure, and productive online. So let's head over to the desktop and check out some of the settings on Google Chrome. From the Chrome home screen, you'll see that you have options to go back to your frequently visited web pages. And also, when you scroll up to the top, you see the little grid menu here. That gets you easy access to all of your Google. So I like to just keep the ones that I use most often there. Next, I want to bring your attention to the top right-hand corner where you see the three dots. They call them the ellipsis. That's where you see all my extensions are hiding, but we also have a few options here. So first, let's take a look at settings. And the settings are important here because make sure that you're signed into the right account. You can go into your sync to make sure you're synced up across all your devices. And let's just scroll down a bit. This is where you would set your home button, so that if you want your home page to always be there on your bookmarks bar, you can show or hide your bookmarks bar. Like right now, I have it hidden, but then if I want to show it, I would just show that. Then you pick your font sizes and all those options. But I also want to go down here to this advanced tab, because most of the time it's hidden. But I want you to see that the advanced tabs is where you have your privacy and security settings. So from here, we want to take a look at our extensions. And one of the things that I've done is add a quick bookmark in my bookmarks bar to my extensions. So here's the page with the extensions. And this has changed recently. The layout of it is more on a grid layout than before when it was in sort of a list format. So this is really handy. And let's just take a look at some of the extensions that I have installed. And I'm bringing these to your attention because not only do they help with these tutorials that I do, like with screen sharing, but also you're going to see one of my favorites. So here's the Appear In. Now that's one I've done a tutorial on that you can use when you just want to have a small group of folks that you want to give some instructions, or you just want to do some collaboration, and you have a screen sharing extension for that. Now let's just scroll down a bit. Also very popular is the Facebook screen sharing. So when you go live on Facebook from your desktop, you have to have that extension installed on Chrome. So let's move down a little bit more. Now I want to introduce you to my favorite, and that's TubeBuddy. You guys know that if you have a YouTube channel, TubeBuddy is your go-to must-have extension for Chrome. Thanks so much for watching that. And I see we have some folks in the chat. And I want to say good morning to Aunt Capone. He was the first one here. And then I also want to say good morning to Barb T. And happy Easter to everyone. And also Pam.
Hi. Happy Easter.
Okay. So Pam said hi in the chat as well. Okay. So Aunt Capone asked this question. Is this only for desktop? And yes, it is, because the extensions you can only add on desktop. Now, I know that Aunt is on an Android phone. So what happens with Android, each one of these things that we have as extensions will also have an app that you can install to integrate with your phone. So it works differently on the phone, but that's a great idea for a future topic because that's a whole nother tutorial that I will have to explain how it all works. And so, okay, and Aunt is saying, hey, Pam. And I love this comment from Barb. She says, TubeBuddy absolutely rocks. So I wanted, yes. Now, Pam, can you see the comments that I'm bringing up on screen? I forgot to ask
you. Yes, I can.
Okay, great. I want to see how you guys to see how I can change them on the fly. Notice that it was a background there behind Barb's comment, but now there's no background. But in this case, I think I do need the background to make it a little bit more visible. Or what I can do is change the color of it and then really make it visible by using green color. So you can see that. And, you know, what one of the things that I was going to do today, you're welcome, Aunt, was to, Barb says she's in her rabbit avatar this morning. Because she's got the little pigtails. Is that why you said that, Barb? And she's got her little pup there. And one of the things that I was going to do this morning was to show how you can do this with Periscope. So the same thing that we're doing live right now on YouTube, we could also be doing the same options on Periscope, including bringing up these comments on screen, changing their properties on the fly. But I just wanted to mention that really quickly and see if you have any other questions about Chrome. So, Pam, is Chrome your primary browser?
It is. I actually am using TubeBuddy, but I've not tried all of these features yet on Chrome, so I've got something to do.
Okay, yeah. And there's a few more things that I didn't get a chance to show in that video. I wanted to keep the video short. You know, that's my new segment, the Media Mogul Moments, all those things that can help you quickly take control of your digital media and your digital presence online. And so that's always going to be up at the front. So if you're ever watching any of my live streams in the future and you're short on time, just know that you can go to the beginning of the video and you can watch the moment, the mogul moment at the beginning. However, you want to stay until the end because I always throw in some kind of a bonus tip during the conversation. And good morning, Larry. And Larry, if you are available on Skype, let me know because we may be able to get more than two people on cam. So Pam, tell me, let's just talk about TubeBuddy, because I know Ann Capone started his YouTube channel, and I was saying to myself one day, I was watching Ant's videos, and I was like, I wonder if Ant knows about TubeBuddy. And so Pam, if you could tell us some of your experience that you've had and the growth that you had on your channel since you started using TubeBuddy.
Oh, it's been awesome. Since I started using TubeBuddy, I lost a couple other platforms where my videos were stored. And there was like 250 videos. I started to panic because I had nowhere to store them or to update the descriptions. Then I was introduced to TubeBuddy by you, Ileane, first of all. Yes! Props for Ileane. And in a matter of minutes, I was able to upload 250 videos that I had created on Periscope and elsewhere in a matter of minutes with the TubeBuddy app. In addition to that, there's been keyword searches and sorting that I've done over a period of 3 or 4 months. I've seen, I mean, tremendous growth on two channels, Oh Natural Aromatherapy and also Tech Talk Live. And I'm just so happy and grateful to Ileane for introducing me to TubeBuddy. It is an awesome, awesome tool, guys. If you're not using it, check it out.
Yes, yes. And one of the other things that I want to mention, too, on that same note with TubeBuddy is that they now have a mobile extension. Now, this is iOS only, so don't get mad at me, Aunt Capone, if you're still there. It's coming. It is coming to Android. They are working to get it, you know, to all with all the different Android devices. So that's being worked on right now. But I was on the beta. I had to keep it quiet. Do you know how hard it was for me? I was biting my tongue every time somebody would say something about TubeBuddy. I want to say, hey, I'm in the beta for the app. So I can say it now. So, yeah, so that was fun. And getting a chance to, you know, chime in on some of the features. And I want to say good morning to Carla. Happy Easter. And no, this is not an April Fool's Day. It's really me and Pam.
Yep.
So yes. Glad you could make it, Carla, on this early, early edition. I wanted to make sure that I caught you guys all before you went to your services and all of that Sunday stuff that you normally do. So, yeah. So let's just really quickly go back to TubeBuddy and why it's so important and how it helps you. For one thing, it will give you a checklist. Okay, so one of the things that we do, we're so busy. We're, you know, doing so many things. We have to keep up with our Facebook, and we have to keep up with our Twitter and you know, our podcast, you know.
Instagram,
because Instagram is just incredible. Even if you're not using Facebook, or if those of you think about leaving Facebook, you're still kind of got one foot in the door because you got to use Instagram because Instagram is just incredible, right? And as a matter of fact, I did a quick Instagram story. Let everybody know I was going live. I don't know if any of you guys saw it. Maybe Larry did. I'm not sure.